In part 3 of our lesson on the trig form of complex numbers, you will learn how to convert from trig form to rectangular form. In this example, we have to convert to rectangular form. Z is equal to 5 cis 7 pi over 6. So right now, Z is in trig form, and we want to change it to rectangular form. First, it's a great idea to draw a picture of Z. We know that theta is 7 pi over 6, which means we're in quadrant 3. And we know that r is equal to 5. Now, using our definitions here, we can do the conversion. We know that x is equal to r cosine of theta, which is 5 times the cosine of 7 pi over 6. We know that our reference angle is pi over 6. So we know the value for cosine is going to be radical 3 over 2. And in quadrant 3, we know cosine is negative. So this is going to be 5 times negative rad 3 over 2, which is equal to negative 5 radical 3 over 2. And that is our x value. Y is equal to r sine of theta. So that's going to be 5 times the sine of 7 pi over 6, which is 5 times, looking at our special angle chart in the pi over 6 column, we see that the value for sine is 1/2, and in quadrant 3, we know it will be negative. So our y value is negative 5/2. We have to write z in rectangular form. We know that means z is going to be x plus y times I. So substituting in the x value that we found and the y value that we found, we know that z will equal negative 5 radical 3 over 2 minus 5/2 I. In this example, we have to convert to rectangular form. Z equals 12 cis 2 pi over 3. Because theta is 2 pi over 3, we know that z is in quadrant 2. And we know its radius is 12. Using our definitions, we know x will be r cosine of theta, which is 12 times the cosine of 2 pi over 3, which is equal to 12 times. We know our reference angle is pi over 3. Looking at our special angle chart, we go to the pi over 3 column in the cosine row. the value is 1/2, and in quadrant 2, cosine is negative. So our x value is going to be negative 6. Y is equal to r sine of theta, so that's going to equal 12 times the sine of 2 pi over 3, which is equal to 12 times, we know our reference angle's pi over 3, we go to the sine row, and the value is radical 3 over 2, and in quadrant 2, we know sine is positive. So our y value is going to be 6 radical 3. We have to put z into rectangular form. Which we know will look like z is equal to x plus y times I. So substituting in our value of x and our value of y, we get that z is equal to negative 6 plus 6 radical 3 times I. And it's perfectly fine to leave your answer like this, but it's quite customary to write it as z is equal to negative 6 plus 6i radical 3. In this example, we have to convert to rectangular form. Z is equal to 3 sis 41 degrees, and we will round our values to the 10,000ths place. So theta is 41 degrees. We know that's in quadrant 1. And we know that r is equal to 3. Using the definitions, we can convert x is equal to r cosine theta. So that will be 3 times the cosine of 41 degrees. And so now we grab our calculators. 3 times the cosine of 41, and we get 2.2641, rounding to the 10,000ths place. Y is r times the sine of theta, so that's going to be 3 times the sine of 41 degrees. Going to our calculators, we get 3 times the sine of 41, and rounding to the 10,000ths place, we see we're going to get 1.9682, and that's our y value. We have to write z in rectangular form. We know is z is equal to x plus y times I, so we substitute in our value for x and our value for y, and we get that z is equal to 2.2641 plus 1.9682i.